do this because it's right. It's the right thing to do. It's right to house people. It's right to educate people. It's right to make things more equitable. The mission to take care of people and to look out for the least of these is right. To make a community that is safe for everybody to be in. To change the mindset of people who have been so oppressed and forgotten. That's the right thing to do.
We only have one life in this form. And what we're doing with that life is incredibly important, not only to us and our families and our communities, but to everyone that will come after us.
Despite what some people would have you believe, you could actually make a huge difference by yourself with your specific work for the rest of your life if you want to, if that's what you endeavor to do.
If you are passionate about community and economic development, then be brave and go out there and test and do something and become an owner in your community, because what else are we doing?
Failure is not when you do something and it didn't work. Failure is when you don't even make the attempt to do something that you know you should do.
It's not as bad as you think it is, so just take the leap. And if it doesn't work out, it doesn't work out.
If choosing your priorities in life is a worthwhile risk, then being an entrepreneur and hanging your own shingle and doing your own thing is amazing.
When we talk with young people about risk-taking, we have to remind them what the real risk is. It's kind of an opportunity cost. If I spend my time doing this, I'm not spending my time doing something more productive. Weighing what those two end results are makes it clear that the risk is often worthwhile.
Think through and imagine the worst thing that could happen, the worst possible outcome. And if that is an outcome that you can accept, that you can still wake up the next day and want to live life, then that is a risk worth taking.
If you're gonna be a risk taker, you've gotta be vulnerable. You have to be able to accept failure and don't let it freeze you. Continue to move forward.
You have to have a vision for a better future. You have to have the passion to work towards that better future.
It's really having long-term vision and being able to tap into that. What could the future look like? And I think that the concept of being excited about what the future could look like is sister to the concept of innovation.
Innovation involves everyone. I wouldn't be sitting here talking to you about innovation or working on this project if it wasn't for all of the people that I've talked to. It doesn't happen with one person or in a vacuum. I think it takes a lot of people and a lot of conversation.
I might only have $5 to put into this project, but actually I have a lot to contribute in different ways.
Yeah.
And that if we're part of this space together, we actually get further.
Everybody has a place. Everybody have a role, and everybody should be proud of the role that they play, because one person can't do it.
The impact doesn't have to be an act of Congress. A good idea can just be a good idea, no matter whether it's young people, older people, or in between.
We blame all the ills of the world on the young people, but who do the young people learn from?
I think it's been proven over and over again that investing in young people makes sense, and getting young people familiar with the concepts of entrepreneurship is tying them into Michigan's entrepreneurial heritage and putting them in a position to be part of this next wave.
We should be focused on investing in and helping to grow the businesses that we already have and shifting the mindset of our youth to be entrepreneurs, to think like entrepreneurs, to find a problem and to try to think of an innovative solution to that problem and then market that idea and grow it into a business.
We have to figure out a way to make these two worlds, the world of these really creative people who are interested in doing business but aren't quite sure how to do it, with individuals who have all the tools, all of the knowledge on how to make that happen, but sort of aren't as aware that this other community exists.
Are we building the opportunity to pursue happiness? Are people picking a career or picking a project or picking a business that they want to do because they love doing that? And then gather the skill sets around that interest and help them figure out how to monetize it and get organized in a way that makes them have a successful business doing the thing that makes them happy.
The work of opportunity and opening doors to opportunity is very important. In our country, we have a lot of disparities that really undermine someone's ability to be successful and grow a business.
It's only in this world do we actually put a value system on people. Poor people are expendable. A lot of times, black and brown people, they're expendable to a lot of people. It's not right, and we're here to say that everybody matters. So then, therefore, we're gonna stand up for those who have been told all of their life, your life does not matter. That's not true.
We talk a lot about the middle class in this country, but there are individuals who are not middle class, who are surviving and who've survived for decades. And so how do you think that's happening? And so I think it's really important to get into the community to earn a level of trust where you can have honest conversations about those things. And once you start to get that intel, that really rich community intel, you get that before you start building the programs.
It's very easy in Michigan, and it has been for the last number of years, to get stuck in a rut. But I think if you have open and honest communication, you have the ability to admit when you don't know something, but you're going to find out the answer. And then you have examples, and you're willing to do trials in a community to bring the public along with your idea and show proof of concept. I really think those three things can help move any innovative idea forward.
There are people that live in those communities, the social environments that your economic development is taking place in. And conversations have to happen. How can I best incorporate my local community and their culture into my business somehow? When people feel heard, they're more supportive.
Listening to the different perspectives, points of view, what's important to some people, what's not important to other people, understand that everything that's important to me may not be important to you, and vice versa.
I think that's one of the keys to coming up with new ideas, is listening to challenges that they face. You might hear the same thing 90% of the time, but it's that 10% of the time where you hear something new or hear a new way that the same problem is explained, and then we can start generating new ideas from there.
When you're trying to solve problems, you have to allow for space for flow, and most of us don't. We are more focused on you being in the office 40 hours a week than we are with you coming up with an idea.
Getting rich is not what most people are going to want to do when it comes towards the end of their life. What they're going to want to have done was pursue something that made them happy, have really good relationships, build a community around them, and look back and not really have any regrets.
If you're going to go off in this direction of spreading inspiration around and bringing innovation to a market, be prepared to have a long view on this. Any kind of real innovative change does not happen overnight.
But if you continually strive toward what should be done and make small successes continuously over and over again, in 10 or 15 years you look back and you're amazed at how much progress has been made.
I really do feel a sense of collective responsibility because I believe that it makes a difference. And if everybody felt that it made a difference, our community would be better. It would be stronger.
Anything is possible. Don't just sit there and watch your community be destroyed or watch it go down. If you have a little bit of faith and a little bit of courage and a little bit of heart, and you get with other people who have courage and faith and heart, you can make it happen. People always say, you have to be at the table, you have to be at the table. Create the table.
I would say to anyone who is really passionate about equality, about closing the gap, really passionate about community development and community revitalization, if you're not looking at community capital and thinking about where your role in this movement is, then you're not thinking about it deeply enough. This is the bedrock of how we revitalize our society for the long term.
What's the point? Is the point just to be able to say that you did it? Or is the point to make meaningful change?